Hi, this is Jacob Ninan from Bangalore, India, and I'm happy to bring you another pointer along the way. These are brief weekly messages on practical aspects of the Christian life, sent out also by email, WhatsApp, and Facebook. All the previous messages are available in the text form on my website, Comfort and Counsel, at www.c-n-c.org. May the Lord bless you as you read or listen to these messages. This is pointer number 800 and it is called What is Grace? If you are blessed through this message, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. When religions show us different ways to become pleasing to God and secure our eternity, many from Christian backgrounds also assume similar ideas. They rely on their good behavior, church attendance, Bible reading, prayer, etc. to gain credits before God. Some boast in keeping the Ten Commandments and think that since they are Christians and aren't committing any serious sins, God can't refuse them admission to heaven. They get angry with those who say that salvation is a gift that cannot be earned. Grace, as an unmerited favor shown by God towards those who actually deserve punishment in hell, is clearly unreasonable to anyone who thinks, "How can he call me a sinner? How can God send good people to hell? How can he ignore all the sacrifices I have made? How can it be right to say that it is simply by believing in Jesus that people can be accepted?" But look at it another way. Is there anyone in the whole world who has never done anything wrong, in deed, word, or thought? When God, who is holy and without sin, looks at all the sins that we have done, can he just overlook any of them? Don't we have to honestly admit that we too deserve punishment? So, here is the situation. The whole world deserves punishment, and there is nothing anyone can do to earn forgiveness from God. But God is love, and he doesn't want to punish any of us whom he has created. In his love and wisdom, he chose to take all of our punishment on himself, so that we could be spared. That is why Jesus died on the cross, the sinless one bearing the punishment for our sins. That is grace. This good news of grace is open to everyone, but only those who accept its terms can receive it. Anyone who admits that they deserve the punishment of hell for their sins, and that it is only because Jesus has died in their place that they can receive forgiveness, receives forgiveness freely. Those who aren't sorry for their sins and those who don't really want to stop sinning can't receive this gift, even though it is free. Grace has two parts: forgiveness for the sins we have done and help to overcome temptations in the future. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 16. Therefore, let us draw near with confidence to the throne of grace, so that we may receive mercy and find grace to help in time of need. 1 John chapter 1 verse 9. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and righteous to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. All who have truly come into grace get help to overcome their sinful nature in the different situations of life and become more and more godly. Titus chapter 2 verses 11 and 12. For the grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation to all men, instructing us to deny ungodliness and worldly desires, and to live sensibly, righteously, and godly in the present age. Grace has been distorted in many ways. Since grace is free, everyone will be ultimately getting saved. Since it is a free gift from God, there is nothing we need to do from our part. Since we are covered in the righteousness of Christ, God doesn't look at our actual lives. Since grace covers all our sins, including the future ones, there is no need to confess our sins. There is no need to deny ourselves when we are tempted, because the Holy Spirit will fight for us. We mustn't listen to any voice that convicts us, because there is no condemnation for us. Our old nature has been taken away, and we have only to rejoice and give thanks, etc. Have we come to know the true grace of God? May the Lord bless you as you have listened to this message. Thank you.